have sunset in Rhode Island at 4:15. 4:15.
On Capitol Hill, the Sunshine Protection Act has received rare bipartisan support. The bill would make daylight savings time permanent, meaning that we would no longer have to change our clocks twice a year. Justice Clarence Thomas has fallen ill with flu-like symptoms this week. The court says it is not COVID and has not released any more information. Also, the Senate will vote on Ketanji Brown Jackson as the newest member of the Supreme Court on April 4th. Destructive wildfires and tornadoes continue to ravage the southwestern United States. The fires have burned over 100,000 acres of land and are only about 80% contained.
Welcome to
HTV.
Hello, I'm Simone.
I'm Rachel.
And I'm Hazel.
And we'll be your anchors for this week's show.
Thank you, Jonas, for the 1 minute news clip.
Our next video is Question of the Week.
What's your favorite movie, and instead of saying it, can you act it out?
What's your favorite dance, and can you do it?
My favorite dance is the robot, I guess, and...
Your dance is a little song made up called the Jonathan Shuffles.
Alright, here it is.
Yeah. Alright, so I have copyright on it, though.
Recently, a few of our Hamilton students have gone missing after an adventure throughout the Peppermint Lounge. This sparks the excitement in all of us to know what happened, and recently we have found and located some of this mysterious footage that may have been the last thing we have ever seen of them.
Roll the clip!
Hey guys, this is HTV. We're gonna go film a video of the Peppermint Lounge. It's gonna be really cool.
Oh, the lights are on. That's good.
Oh. And also, I'm the cameraman, so hello. Yeah, I'm the cameraman.
Guys, dude.
Whoa.
See that?
It says the Peppermint Lounge. Why does that L look like a C?
Pound.
That's funny.
A dark tunnel.
A dark tunnel? A tripod.
Guys, look.
Do you think it could have been...
Whoa.
Do you think this could have been left by the clavicle kleptomaniac?
Clavicle kleptomaniac, so scary.
He was a student that lived here in the 1940s.
Guys, I know you guys. Oh, whoa. What? What was that?
He died. And then his name was Jesus Ryan before he died.
Jesus Ryan. That doesn't sound like a ghost. Yeah.
Whoa.
Flashlight time.
Hey.
Well, I'm going to go over here because it's like scary.
I don't think we're just going to assault the ghost, guys.
I don't think there's nothing back there.
There is no ghost. It's just a myth. It's not true. It's a legend.
Wait outside.
Oh, God! It's a clavicle kleptomaniac!
What is that? What?
Hezekiah? Cameron? We can't just leave them there. Cameron?
I'm good. I see Roz.
Where did the clavicle kleptomaniac go?
I don't know. I think he went in one of the tunnels.
What happened?
This guy has a cat.
There's a cat that got.
Where is he? Where'd he go? He was right there.
Who?
Hezekiah. Where'd he go?
Hezekiah?
I swear
he was here though.
Funny prank. Good job.
What's that sound?
Good job, Hezekiah.
Mr. Clavicle?
Good job, guys.
What's that sound? What's that sound? What's that sound? You guys hear that? Yeah.
Funny joke.
Good job. We're laughing too hard, Hezekiah.
I feel like this isn't scary. What the heck? You can come out now. Funny joke.
Don't even taunt him, Devin, unless you want to be dead.
It's too. A joke. It's not.
No. That was so scary, though. How can that be a joke?
No, no.
It was a joke.
No.
Come on, let's go.
See?
It's just Hezekiah, right?
It's just a joke. It's not a joke. It's not a joke. Ah!
Oh, here we go.
The door! It won't open!
Out the door!
No! It won't open! Oh no!
The imposter is us!
Hey Simone, do you know anything about basketball?
No, I'm tall though.
Well, good thing Aiden does, and he's here to tell you his March Madness predictions.
Roll the clip!
Alright, hello. We're gonna talk about possible March Madness upsets. So, we got a few teams written here. See, we got a goated basketball with March Madness. Pretty lit. But, first matchup that I think could be an upset is Arkansas versus Vermont. Arkansas has lost to some mediocre teams this year, and Vermont, I'm pretty sure, won their tournament. So, I just think that could be. And next matchup, number 6, Alabama versus number 11, Rutgers or Notre Dame. I think that this Rutgers, I think, is probably gonna make it for this game. I think that they can beat them, and Alabama is kind of ranked pretty high from what I have seen. And then the next matchup, Michigan State versus Davidson. Davidson's pretty good. They won their tournament. I think they're ranked lower than what they should be. Next matchup is number 5, St. Mary's versus Wyoming or Indiana. Indiana will probably win versus Wyoming to get to the tournament, and then they'll play St. Mary's, and I think that could end in an Indiana win. Next one, Virginia Tech versus Texas. Virginia Tech is very hot right now. They beat Duke in the ACC tournament championship to win the ACC tournament. So I think that could be a good matchup, and I think Virginia Tech could win that. My next one is number four, Illinois versus number 13, Chattanooga. I think that this could be a good match. This will probably be a good matchup, but I think Chattanooga could win. They won because they're a mid-major. They won their tournament, and I think, because Illinois, not very hot right now. They just lost to Indiana, which I said earlier. So we got number 7, Ohio State versus number 10, Loyola Chicago. I think Loyola could win this game because Ohio State just came off a Big Ten tournament loss where they lost to Penn State, which was very unexpected. They were heavy favorites in the game, but Penn State was able to win. So I think Loyola has a good shot. And also they got Sister Ruth, I think is her name. Yeah, a few years ago they went to the Final Four. For her. Next up, we got number 7 USC versus number 10 Miami. I think Miami could win this. It's gonna be a good matchup either way, though. I think this one could go either way, but I think Miami could definitely pull this one out. See you next March. Go Badgers. If the Badgers don't win, I'm gonna be sad. Peace out.
My flexibility lately? I still can't do a cartwheel. Can you?
Yeah, I can. Let's see if these other Hamilton students can cartwheel.
Roll the clip.
Question of the week this week is, can you cartwheel? And if so, can you show us?
I can do I might be able to do a cartwheel.
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay, so
I can try to do one.
Okay, go ahead, sign me.
Tomorrow's your promotional support.
Emotional support. Thank you.
on tests?
Totally not.
Roll the clip.
Yo, do you remember the new Fortnite
season? Yes, bro, I dropped
it. What? Sit down, it is time for a test.
Thanks,
we'll see how smart you really are. Pencils out.
For some 7th grade videos.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
Fire truck.
Do you mean a firefighter?
No.
Okay.
I want to be a cat owner.
Rock star. Filmmaker. Oh, are you one of the teaching assistants?
Oh, I'm Nadia. I'm going to be a film student at USC.
My back. What do y'all want to be when you grow up?
My turn. So I'm not
good. This is just getting further and further away from being in school.
Fire truck.
Yeah, you mean
firefighter?
You mean firefighter?
No.
I want to be a cat mom.
Filmmaker.
I don't know.
You ready?
Teacher. I'm your mother. Oh, do you art? Oh, are you a student teacher?
Grip, 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 then it won't let go. Whoa. Pressure like a tick, tick,
2014, a book you won't want to miss, yeah. The Crossover.
Yeah.
And now, a sneak peek of the old book.
Yeah.
Already came, but it's back, so you better read it before it dunks all over you.
And now, the trailer begins.
Hey, JB, wanna go shoot some hoops?
Nah, I can't. Me and my girlfriend were just texting. I got a date with her later. Her name's Miss Sweetie. I don't want to play with you anymore.
Come on, I want to play. I'm sorry. Yeah, come on.
Come on. Here you go.
Oh. This channel's bad.
Hey, JB, this song. I'm sorry. Hey.
Can Josh deal with JB being mad at him, his dad being sick, and winning the championship game? 3, 2, 1, 0! Read the crossover to find out.
Hamilton,
peace.